Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Sonic CD. In our last episode, we explored the fourth level of the game, Quartz Quadrant. And in this episode, we are going to explore the fifth level of the game, Wacky Workbench, which has simultaneously one of the silliest names in Classic Sonic, but also one of the most fitting because we are apparently in some giant factory that Dr. Eggman has built. For what purpose is beyond me, because it's definitely wacky. There are a lot of hazards in this stage. This is easily the most hazardous and treacherous stage that we've encountered yet. And one of the main hazards is this flashing, electrified, bouncing floor. It doesn't hurt you, but if you happen to touch the floor, Sonic will suddenly get skyrocketed to the top of the screen, and this will send him up to higher portions of the level that normally you might not be able to access. It's both a blessing and a curse because it lets you get up to higher sections. However, if you're trying to get your bearings, it can be pretty hard to do if you're constantly bouncing up and down off of the floor because, you know, look at that. See how high it sent me? I got sent almost to the very top of the level. And that's gonna happen a lot in this stage. And then you got these spinning platforms. I like that sprite, by the way. They actually went out of the way to create a unique sprite for Sonic from when he's on those spinning platforms. Nice touch. Very nice touch. You also got these weird platforms that you have to jump on like a seesaw from one end to the other in order to make it ascend or descend, depending on what you want to do. And this level is just, like I said, it's obviously some kind of factory, but what for is beyond me, because this is not any type of factory I'd want to end up in. I don't think OSHA would be very pleased with Dr. Eggman's work here. It doesn't look like this would be a very safe work environment. Honestly, I don't know what I was doing here. I was trying to get this platform here to go up. I've been here for, what, at least a minute? I don't know what I was trying to do here. And then look, I finally get up and a freaking freeze laser hits me in midair and I fall all the way back down. This level, I am definitely not a fan of this stage. I definitely find it one of the more frustrating levels to deal with, simply because of the sheer amount of obstacles and things like that that can happen. And at this point, I don't know why at this point, I think at this point I finally got the hint that I was never gonna see what was actually up there. Yeah, also you gotta worry about electric currents. That's another hazard of the bouncing floor. You often will not have any idea what you're actually gonna get bounced up into. For all you know, you could either be sent to a platform or to a hazard like that electric current that I am currently climbing over. I like that touch too. Another unique animation from when Sonic is on that bar. Oh, and then you got that where you get on that little platform thing and you get launched. There's also another hazard that we haven't quite seen yet, where there's a pattern in the background that is actually a bunch of Tesla coils and stuff connected to each other, and periodically that pattern in the background will become electrified, and if you touch the part of the background that is electrified, it works like any other hazard. You're going to get hit and it's gonna hurt. So I came up there for nothing. Like, I was doing a lot of going out of my way to try and find some type of coherent path through this stage, but it's downright impossible. Now, this is the electrified background thing I was talking about. Those little nodes or whatever, they have little coils of electric wire connecting them, and they're in these nice little patterns and such. And I don't know what the point was of that platform going up, because it didn't really seem like it led anywhere. So, look at that, 4 minutes and 47 seconds. I honestly don't know what I was doing. I should have just kept going straight through. think I ended up looking like an idiot for the most part, but we get through Zone 1, and it's on to Zone 2, and luckily, since we no longer have to worry about the time stones, we collected the last one in the previous episode, we no longer have to worry about going through the special stages or anything like that. So, the remaining episodes for this LP are going to be a little bit shorter. They're going to go much more quickly, hopefully. I haven't reviewed... It's been a while since I reviewed most of the footage for this LP because... a lot of the footage for this LP has been sitting on my hard drive for the last few months, and I'm just now actually getting to it for the LP. Ugh. I think I was about to get motion sick inside that spinning thing. So yeah, welcome to the past version of Wacky Workbench. I had actually thought going in that I had actually stopped visiting the past versions of the stages, but apparently not. And get hit by a spiked trap and get crushed. There's your fail. Or, you know, as Adam Savage would say from Mythbusters, there's your problem. Mythbusters, I haven't watched that in a long time. But we're not talking about Mythbusters, we're talking about Sonic CD. And as you can see, this is essentially before Wacky Workbench became a massive factory. Here, it apparently... Wacky Workbench was once a massive canyon, and there's all this construction work going on, so Eggman definitely has something big in the works here. But again, like, what is the point? What was the point of this factory? Just to torment whoever entered it? Also, you got the electrified background objects. You got these weird poles that Sonic will spiral down, and if you press the jump button, depending on which side you're on, you'll go off in a certain direction. And of course, the bouncing floor is there. And it, like I said, it's such a silly name, Wacky Workbench. It's like, I think they were trying a little bit too hard for the alliterative level title. But it lives up to its name. It's kind of like what I said about Collision Chaos. It seems like it's something they drew randomly out of a hat, but it lives up to its name. And the electrified background makes its presence known. Now, one thing you may be noticing is that there aren't really any badniks in this past version of Wacky Workbench. Much like destroying the actual roboticizers, once you have all the time stones, the badniks, for the most part, disappear in the past. It's really just the natural level hazard you have to deal with, as evidenced by our little journey through this level. What with the electrified stuff, and still the bouncing floor. But welcome to the good future of Wacky Workbench, where it's still a factory, but apparently it's taken on the motif of being a toy factory. Like, you know, it's all bright. And this actually has one of my favorite music tracks in the game, at least if you're listening to the Japanese soundtrack. Yes, that's right. I can't believe I've actually gotten this far without actually mentioning it. But Sonic CD actually has two different soundtracks. There's the original Japanese soundtrack, which I think is the better one. And then there was the American soundtrack, which was originally added when Sonic CD first came to America. Which isn't a bad soundtrack, but I far and away prefer the Japanese soundtrack. I think it fits the game better, the tracks are catchier and more memorable. And I don't know, the Japanese soundtrack for Sonic CD is one of my favorite video game soundtracks of all time. And that's a big deal for someone like me, because... You know, gameplay ultimately is always important for me, but I definitely think a good soundtrack is a big part of the experience for me. Because a good soundtrack is a great way to get me immersed into a game. Now anyway, the boss fight for Dr. Eggman here, as you have seen, is you hit him, he goes up, drills into the ceiling, you have to wait for these crumbling pieces of level to come down, you'll then be shot up, and then you just have to go up and hit him. And Eggman will run away once again. And that is it 4 Wacky Workbench. Of course, we have the little extra segment for this episode. It's now time to take a glimpse at the bad future, which is much grittier and by far more hazardous than the other time zones, because the in Wacky Workbench Bad Future, the level becomes littered with obstacles, especially those electrified wires in the background. Those things just... the game almost overdoes that particular obstacle in the Bad Future. This is not... the Bad Futures in general are, you know, not very friendly places, but this one may be one of the most treacherous Bad Futures in the whole game, simply because of how many more obstacles there are. Like, seriously. A lot of obstacles to deal with, and a level that's obstacle-heavy as it is. But in any case, we are done with Wacky Workbench. The fifth level of the game is out of the way, and that is a wrap for this episode of Let's Play Sonic CD. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it, as always. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. I will see all of you in the next episode.